Meet Alex. Alex is 12. Alex will actually tell you that they are 12 years, 3 months, and 8 days old. Alex lives in foster care with their two foster parents. Alex is a baker and makes 3 recipes in rotation. The rest of the class gets really excited for Fridays because that's when Alex brings in the cookies. Alex has their baking method down to a fine science, which is true of most things Alex does. And that's not all Alex is good at. Alex loves computers and is the go-to person for tech support for the whole class and even the teacher. Alex's favorite thing to do is to predict the weather. At this point, Alex has a 78.6% success rate for predicting weather patterns around their neighborhood. At recess, you'll find Alex atop of the grassy hill, where they have the best viewpoint of the sky. If you ever need to know what to wear for the weather, ask Alex. Just the other day, when Jared waved Alex over to play at recess, Alex didn't wave back. It's not that Alex wants to be rude. They actually didn't know what Jared was doing. And while Alex can talk for hours about the weather, baking, or computers, they have a really hard time talking about what other people are interested in. This can be frustrating for the other kids. Alex finds it hard to understand what other people are thinking or feeling, and it can even be hard for them to look people in the eye. They find it overwhelming. And speaking of overwhelming, a busy classroom can also be a tricky place for Alex. All the noise, the bright lights, and the smell of the other kids' lunches are sometimes just too many variables for Alex to handle. Alex was born with a brain that works differently. They have something called autism spectrum disorder. Alex's brain sees, hears, feels, and smells the world in a unique way. Things that may come easily to other people can be harder for somebody like Alex. Like making friends, understanding feelings, and playing in groups. Sometimes this can feel lonely for Alex. Even though Alex is great at spelling words correctly, they have a really hard time making stories with those words. When Alex was 4 years old, their foster parents learned that Alex had autism. That's when help started for Alex and their family. Alex has a special support worker who helps Alex practice friendship skills and how to better notice how other people feel. Alex is also working on strategies to help them handle the busy classroom. Other helpers in Alex's team are foster parents, the family social worker, and the pediatrician. One more thing about Alex. They are terrified of elevators. Alex will panic when they see an elevator. Even the thought of going to visit their friend who lives in an apartment building makes Alex feel like they can't breathe. They take the stairs all the way up, 12 floors. This is called a specific phobia. We all feel afraid or creeped out by things sometimes, but a phobia is way bigger. When someone has a phobia, it gets in the way of them doing the things they need to do. Alex is working with a therapist to help manage the phobia. All the other kids in the class are starting to understand Alex a little better. They make sure to invite them to join in at recess, which really helps Alex feel included. Alex loves to keep score for all the games and is tracking the results in a special app. After one of the games, Alex and Angela made plans to bake cookies together for next Friday. What could possibly go wrong?